So what are low-rise, mid-rise, high-rise building, and then what are skyscrapers? Hey guys, I'm Suleiman Khan and you are watching An Engineer Boy. Alright, so actually there is no hard rule when it comes to classify structures or buildings as low-rise, mid-rise, high-rise or maybe skyscraper, because every city, every country's planning department will have its own definition, or you can say the exact classification varies by countries and organizations. For example, in Pakistan, a high-rise starts at 5 stories. However, in the US, a high-rise is an apartment building with a height of at least 7 stories, and that's defined by the National Fire Protection Association. Okay, so let's talk about what Asians have about this classification. My country classifies as a building with height of at least 4 stories, maybe known by the low-rise building. They are closer to street, they provide better access to green space, they have more amenities in parking, they are located in residential areas, they may be cheaper with greater peace and privacy. Now, buildings with 5 to 10 stories are considered or may be known by the mid-rise buildings. Structures or buildings with 11 to 40 stories are known by the high-rise buildings. And then finally, skyscrapers are the buildings, you can say, are structures with more than 40 stories. These buildings are located in the city. They offer the best view in more natural light, you can say. They provide a doorman or security guard. They always have elevators. They offer more leasing options and vacancies. They have easier utilities and maintenance and something such. So this is how we can classify the mid-rise, low-rise, high-rise, and then skyscrapers.